always any teacher, any student. So the student whom the teacher is confident, he will be called last. Because so he wants to motivate all the students, he doesn't want to demotivate all the students, that's why. And he is called as the last student. So Arjuna came. Hey, my dear Arjuna, what do you see? I only see bullseye. I only see eye of the parrot. I can't see tree. I can't see peak of the tree. I can't see a pole. I can't see a parrot. All that I can see is only eye. All that I can see, only I, only I, only I, not just I, only see, retina, retina, all that I see is only a retina, the lens, the lens, the lens. What he said? He is seeing only, not parrot eye, he said. And he said, not parrot eye. He said, he is the first, he said, pupil. Then he said, all that I can see is only retina now. What is retina? In your, the black round in the eye. And in the center, there is a small dot, a small one. That is your lens. That's called retina. So what did he say? Arjuna. Arjuna said, all that I see is only retina, not even bullseye, the center of the bullseye, not the red dot, red round circle, but the center of the round circle is only see. And Dronacharya, the coach, said, hey, you are guri, you have a guri, you have a guri. You can one day become a guru. You can. You passed out. You don't have to hit. Hey Arjuna, you don't have to hit. You are proven as a child. I am just testing what your target. When your target itself is only a retina, one day you will get it. All these guys, their target is not, that is the last thing they see. The last thing we see in the spirituality is a singularity. Entire world you look at, you ask what is the singularity. You ask what is Siddhanta Vicharana. No one can explain. You know, all that we see is, you know, oh, I see a beautiful everything here. Beautiful garden in the tree, in the garden, in the tree. Oh my God, the tree is like a maple tree, like a maple tree. So green, so sharp, the leaves are. Oh my God, what kind of trunk it has. Oh my God, what kind of branches it has. All that I want to do is sit on a branch. Oh my God, what a peak like it has, like Everest. And then, oh my God, the parrot on the top. Your spiritual hunt is like this, you know. What is your spiritual? Oh my God, I love Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. What do you like? Oh my God. Lam Vam Ram Yam Ham Om. Lam Vam Ram Yam ham om, lam vam yam ham om, om, om. What is this, Kumar? We never heard. Have you not heard this mantra? Did your Kundalini yoga teacher did not tell you? Are. Very powerful mantra. Lam vam ram yam ham. Om, om. hum yum hum om. Shall we dance? Lum vum rum yum hum om om. Kundalini gets awakened. Dance, rhythmatical, rhythm dance. Gurzaev, a famous Russian mathematician, discovered law of octaves, sound. Oh my God, it is all octaves, you know. Mathematics, you know. Oh my God, if I produce this octave, and I can go into some other trance. And dervish dances like tribals. Dance till the last exhaustion, when you feel tired, lie down, and then naturally you will get the samadhi. You know, dance induced trance, ecstasy. So what you see in spirituality is singularity. Ask your gurus what is singularity. First let them explain. What is the single, what is the way to, what is the, as per the Vedanta, as per the Buddha, what is called the technique of self-realization, what is the technique of self-actualization, what is it called? Listen, how many people will answer that nitya anicca vicharana, sabhe sankara anicca ti, sabhe sankara dukkha ti, sabhe sankara anatta ti, yadha pannaya pasati, atane bhindati dukkha yesa magha visuddhiya. A guru, who is a guru? A Dronacharya, a Bhishmacharya, Shankaracharya, a Buddha. The one who achieved guri is called a guru. What is the singularity? The world through the dark energy, dark matter. All these are the worlds of dark energy, dark matter, gravity. A world beyond called illumining. These are dark. The word, the meaning itself is a dark. Gravity is a dark. Black hole is a dark. Dark energy and is a dark matter. That's why this word is coined how many years back? Since the yoga is born. Dark, neely, you know, so dark blue, dark blue color is dark, black color is a Krishna, black color is a Rama, black color is a Shiva. The color itself is a black, indicating they have accomplished the journey. For what? Illumination. What is not dark matter, what is not dark energy, what is not gravity is called singularity, is called illumination. Tamaso ma jyotirghamaya, tamaso ma jyotirghamaya, asato ma sadghamaya, tamaso ma jyotirghamaya, mrityorma amratangamaya. The one who takes you from dark to illumination. Isn't it? This is what you heard. Guru means who shows the light, you know. Light not here. So many lights are there. I am seeing every day. That is not the light. So you keep xenon lamps in your house. You know I am seeing every day light. That excites you further, that spoils you. So the illumination, imperfection to perfection. Guru is, mean the one who already, who can hit the bullseye, who can coach you, who can take you, who can coach you to hit at the bull's eye only. The target is only bull's eye. Guru means whose target is only retina, singularity. He is called a guru. Huge difference. Because vocabulary, have I not explained, isn't it, this particular word? So I never explained what is a guru, isn't it? Literally. But every word, look at the depth, a story behind the guru. You know, what we see in the spirituality matters. What you are targeting matters. For me as a child, as a youngest, way, the one who is pursuing serious Vedanta, getting trained, I am the youngest among the students. And all my target is, all I could see is the way to singularity. Who will teach me? All my search. Why 86 ashrams? In search of the truth. In search of a guru. Who has a guru? Who knows the singularity? Search, in search of the truth, in search of a guru. Truth you will never get, in search of a guru. A guru means the one who knows guru, target. Target accomplished, mission accomplished. So what is your target? Yoga means asanas, breathing techniques. And yoga means balancing, alignment, whole life. We will align, we'll balance, we will align, we'll balance. How to keep the foot, how to keep this foot, and how to balance, whether that is in the same plane, whether your knee is behind ankle or in the front, how your shoulder is facing. You know. The whole life you want to learn only this. Or the whole life you want to jump, yoga means the whole life, 45 years, whom you worship, the greatest yoga teachers you know in the world, jumping like this, and jumping like that, and going like this, and going like this, going like this, jumping like this. Oh my God, what a complicated postures they can do, and you know how their body looks. You know. Oh my God, how many times they are on the yoga journal poster. You know. What spoiled yoga is the journals. You think there's a yoga? What is your guru? Target only this, isn't it? Your yoga course, mission of doing yoga course means. So, have you searched for? No, Kumar. I don't want Kumar, guru, you know. I want the one who works with this body, you know. Who is interested in this body, crushing the body, and, you know, designing the body. And we are not interested, Kumar, frankly speaking. Because West is very frank always. Hey, we are not interested in singularity, you know. You are learning archery. You are learning, you went for, you know, gun training, rifle training. You are telling coach, I don't want a ring. I don't want a bull's eye. You know, so just you taught, and you just allow me to pull the trigger. That's all. And you know, where the bullet goes, I am not bothered. Is this? Where the bullet goes, whom it hit, who will die? I don't care, who will die. Hey, I have not come here for the coach, Dr. Kumar, in archery. You know, I am not interested. I am only interested in holding the gun and pulling the trigger and whom it hits. I am not bothered. Let people die. The present yoga is only that. Your search for a guru is pulling the trigger, not the one who can train you to at the singularity. A monodirection. Where is monodirection? This, your gun is this side, your gun is this side. Has ever told that as a yogi, yogi means the one who knows only the singularity, guru? Then let's not call yoga, no? Why to spoil that name? It's better we not call yoga, you know? It's better we call exercise. And now you. As a student, you take pride. I am doing power yoga, you know. Do you know what is the power? In your fitness terms, this is how the old tradition indicates. It has no scientific basis at all. And how these guys start separate tradition. You know. And you boast. It is more powerful than Ashtanga. It is more powerful than, you know, alignment and balance. It is very powerful, I discovered. And, you know, this is how the Westerners introduce. Not even understand the science behind it. They label. All that is a beautiful catchy labels. Called power yoga. Where is the power yoga? Where is the power? What do you mean by power? And when people kill yoga like this, you know, and who will come and teach you yoga? Power mongers. Yoga is for power mongers? You know. Who is a guru? Guru is not the one who teaches power yoga. A guru is not the one who teaches alignment, balance, and, you know, so the guru is not the one who teaches, you know, so resistance, weight training. These are only branches. Is a tree. Is it, you are talking about trunk? You are talking about which branch it is? Is one of the branches. Whole life is going only one of the branches. Singularity is here. Whole life is going only one branch. What can I do? Still you are deluded, the one who is hearing this. Already, and he already loves this only one branch. All the tree means for him the branch. One leaf. Not the parrot, not the target. Singularity. I am very happy with this leaf, Kumar. You know, leaf me, no? This what? You went for rifle shooting, and all I learnt is pulling the trigger, Kumar. And if someone comes and tells you, all I learnt is pulling a trigger, you know, so don't ask me the goal. Do you think you will employ him as your bodyguard? You will employ him as a sniper? And he came for interview of a sniper, you know. Interviews as a sniper. And you called for a sniper interview. And he came for, and he's telling, all that I know, this 800 meter, you know, so like 800 meter, how much sniper means? So the guru will ask that. You know. So 850 meters, 1000 meters? Yes. So my gun is very powerful. I know how to pull. Whoever is at 800 meters will die. And on this, no, I saw in the movie, and I'm looking for a sniper, and I saw in a movie, you know, so sniper, when he, sniper means a skill, when he hits a bullet, you know, and he calculates it's a parabolic, anabolic, and parabolic, and, you know, so hyperbolic curves, and he calculates precisely how the bullet goes like this, and it goes like this, how it hits, and he estimates precisely how the bullet goes, and, you know, and he hits straight, but, you know, it hits the target here, or the target here, the target here. Oh my God, I thought, you know, sniper means that. No, sir, all that is not required. Sniper means just holding a 850 meter, you know, so a gun which can shoot at 850 meters with a telescope, that's all. What else, sir? Who told you? So one has to calculate like this, cause estimating, and bullet goes, you know, like this, bullet goes like this. That's what I have seen in a movie. And bullet goes like this, it goes like this, it goes like this, it goes like this. Like rocket goes in the space, you know. So when you say in yoga, oh, I love alignment balance, I love power yoga, I love this. I have seen entire India and entire you. I have seen. There is nothing I have not seen. How many caves you have seen? How many corners in Himalayas you have seen? Where Krishnamacharya went, have you seen? Have you gone? People talk. as if they have probed every cave in Himalayas, as if they explored every book in the libraries in India. People speak this speaking, and I have practiced all this, and this saying is killing yoga, understand? And one thing I tell you is, learn, this India is a karma bhumi. The first selection of a herb, from which area a saffron, the world's best saffron, comes from Kashmir, in particular location. Nowhere, the Spain or Iraq, the saffron quality, when you say, much, much inferior in terms of even the length, the color of the saffron coming from Kashmir. When you want to get the turmeric, the ginger in India, have you tasted? Have you tasted? Ginger in your place, have you tasted? In US or in UK, have you tasted? It is not like a ginger, it is like a cake. You are trying, it is like a cheesecake you are trying to cut. Turmeric in the abroad, have you seen your turmeric? Have it? For me, when I look, is it turmeric or ginger? I get out. Why am I telling you this? Always try to learn yoga from where it is or isn't. And I'm telling you, I'm not sure, had I born in abroad, whether I would have become a yoga teacher or not, a guru or not. I must tell, where the land, the people who are born, all kinds are there in India. But understand, a learning from where the yoga is born, the land where yoga is born. I don't think you ever try in the West, you can chant like me. Can you? Can you understand like me? The sound, the silence. That's why it is said. It is not today. For thousands of years, entire world came only for a purpose of learning yoga to the Takshashila. That is only the university in the world. World is not blind. You know, they came to Takshashila. You know. Why? So, the one who is heading Takshashila, Nalanda, is fully enlightened people. Where they are born? They are born in this land. A land is programmed only to give birth only to the saints, only to remove the karma. You know, understand? How many Abrahams you have? How many Jesus? How many prophet? In India, why we don't have one? Because they're infinite. They're infinite. So where you want to learn? You know, learn from an authentic tradition. If at all if you want to learn, I'm not discouraging you. Learn. But see the huge difference it makes. I'm not encouraging you simply from authentic, from a tradition, the one who has seen, the one who explains, at least some level of intellect you have to use. Who is a guri, who is a guru, from where guru has to come. Yes, there must be people, it is your fault if you believed someone and he cheated you. It is your fault, it is not our fault. Let me tell you, you know, it is your fault. Because you do not know the criteria. That's what I am trying to tell you. You do not know the criteria of selection of a guru. You went behind lam vam ram ham yam na, and you are under delusion. That is it. That's it. I'm. You paid £2,000. I'm. I am prophet. I have become millionaire by selling I am. And when you meditate on that, one animal picture comes when you die. Not gods will come to pick you up. Nimitta. Telling. When you select a mantra like I am. Dangerous mantra. Which is practiced for siddhis. You understand? When you do not know the criteria, it is our fault. I am trying to educate you what you should look for. Understand? First, what a student should look for. You have no idea at all. So that's the reason. Very, very important. If someone, an Indian guru, hey Indian, your own friends, your own foreign teachers only will tell, hey, we went to India, it's all cheating there. You don't believe these guys, so Indian guru. People get scared of Indian gurus. Hey, we have seen some. Our people are very reliable in the West. So these guys in India. Yes, I agree. I said all kinds of the people exist in India. But whom you selected, that you. Selection is yours, not gurus. Selection of guru is yours. It is not gurus. And you selected. He is not actually guru. And you believed him because he said guru. Everyone says guru. And yes. And what he knows, he has taught you. You are not happy. What he did with you, you are not happy. Had I been in your place, I would have been happy. Why would I have been happy? Because at least that much I learned. But I won't stop there like you got. You blame the teacher and you get, oh my God, it is all like that. I won't go to any ashram. I won't go for any guru. No. For me, oh my God, okay, it's all right, no problem. Okay, this guru, at least this much he knows. Okay, what next? Hope makes the world live. Never lose hope. So, I'm seeing the contemporary books read in yoga circles, by books, the books kept by, written by Westerners, and the way as if that book, encyclopedia of yoga, and when I read all this craziness and prescription books, so yoga is in the books now, unfortunately. Does this book talks about selection criteria? No. Does this book talk, all its selection criteria, when you're reading a review, a company already bought that person who is writing a review. And the one who is, talking about any phone on the YouTube is already paid, he is already supplied all the beta versions and everything. And on the top he is paid, he is a highly earning guy, And his review, you hear. All these books in yoga you read. And how many copies sold, how much rich they have become, tell me. That no one thinks, oh my God, this book, latest. Best. Now you observe in last 50 years the books published in yoga in India or in abroad. How many books published in abroad? How many books published in India? Why this craziness of converting yoga into a business of books? Quickly realize. 40, 45 years. How many yogis? Who is yogi? Your very definition of yogi is wrong. Realize. Maybe I am alone. Fight. Doesn't matter at all. Understand. Always the truth is the truth. I can't tell what is not yoga as a yoga. I can't tell what is not a power as a power yoga. I am defining what is a power. You verify. Any fitness book you open, you ask what is the power. All your names, your fallacies, your delusions, your illusions, your selection criteria when it fails, and you get cheated. What else? I don't say you are cheated. You got that much benefited. You may be thinking like that.